Next, our next representation is represented is R503. It is another azeotropic mixture of refrigerants. As R503, it is another azeotropic mixture of 40% R23 and 59.9% R33 refrigerant. Mixture of it is a by nature, by property, it is non-flammable, non-corrosive, non-toxic. Its boiling temperature, atmospheric pressure is -88 degrees centigrade. Its mix is boils at -15 degrees centigrade, and it's -88 degrees centigrade, which was then either R3 and R30. In evaporative temperature is pressure is at 15 degrees centigrade is 17.17 bar. Just one second, R23. Then R22 and R13. Temperature Now, this critical temperature is at 20 degrees centigrade, so it's and its critical pressure is 41.15 bar. Thus, the low temperature refrigerant and good for the use of low state of cascade system, which requires temperature at the range of -70 degrees centigrade to -87 degrees centigrade. The latent heat of vaporization at atmospheric pressure is 173 kilojoule per kg. The leaks in R503 system may be detected with the use of soap solution. A halide torch or a halide torch and electronic leak detector system. This refrigerant will be hold more moisture than some other low temperature refrigerant. It may be noted that all low temperature applicants must have extreme dryness because any moisture not in solution with the refrigerant is likely to form ice at the refrigerant control devices. The oil does not circulate well at low temperatures. The cascade and other low temperature equipments are normally fitted with oil separators and other devices for returning the oil to the compressor. The cylinder color is aquamarine. This is more or less blue, light blue. 503 is aquamarine. R504. This is another azeotropic mixture, 48.2 R32. And 51.8 R150. Non-flammable, non-corrosive, non-toxic. The boiling temperature is -15 degrees centigrade. The evaporative temperature, pressure at -15 degrees centigrade, 5.88 bar. And the critical pressure is 48 bar. As with low temperature, as the low temperature refrigerant, some difficulty may be experienced with the oil circulation. With the addition of 2 to 5% R170 ethane, the oil will be taken to solution with the refrigerant and will circulate through the system with it. The leaks in the R504 system may be easily detected by using soap solution, a halide torch, or an electronic leak detector. This refrigerant is used for industrial process when a low temperature range of -40 centigrade to -82 is desired. The cylinder color code for R504 is tan. Next comes inorganic refrigerants. These are the covers, the ammonia, air, carbon dioxide, sulfur dioxide, water, these are defined as inorganic refrigerant. Ammonia has the name as the number. as per the DuPont system are 717. Air has the number 729, carbon dioxide 744, and sulfur dioxide 764, and water is 118. So what you know, the chemical formula is NH3, air don't have any composition, carbon dioxide, CO2, SO2, and H2O, as usual. In R117 ammonia, the ammonia is one of the oldest and most widely used of all refrigerants. At one sample time, the greatest application is found in large commercial respiratory system, compressor system with high toxicity secondary. It is also widely used in absorption systems. It is a chemical compound of nitrogen and hydrogen, and under ordinary condition, it is a colorless trash. In boiling point, at atmospheric pressure is minus 30 degrees centigrade, and it is melting point from the solid is minus 70 degrees centigrade. So the low boiling point makes it possible to have explosion at temperature below 0 degrees centigrade without using pressure below the atmosphere in the evaporator. Its latent heat of evaporation is at 15 degrees centigrade and is 13.5 kilojoules per kg. These large refrigerating effects are possible with relatively small size machineries. The condenser pressure is 30 degrees centigrade, it's 8.78 bar. Its condensers for R117 are usually of water cooled type. But main problem with ammonia is a poisonous gas. If it's inhaled in large quantities, at lesser quantities, it is irritating to the nose, ear, and throat. The refrigerant is somewhat inflammable, and when mixed with air in the ratio of 35 to 15% of gas by volume, will form an explosive mixture. So, air ammonia plus air mixture is toxic and explosive in nature. The mix of these represent may be quickly easily detected by the use of burning sulfur candle, which in the presence of ammonia forms white fumes of ammonium sulfide. This refrigerant attacks copper bronze in the presence of a little moisture, but does not corrode iron steel. It is corrosive to copper. But non-corrosive. Corrosive to iron and steel. It presents no special problem in connection with the lubricant. Generally, if you mix with the lubricant of the compressor, it doesn't have any problem, but until extreme pressures are encountered here. Since the refrigerant R117 is lighter than oil, therefore, its separation does not create any problem. If excess oil in the evaporator may be removed by the pending opening of valve in the bottom of the evaporator. This refrigerant used in large compressor machines using reciprocating compressors and in many absorption type systems. The use of this refrigerant is extremely found in cold storage, warehouse plants, ice cream manufacturers, ice manufacturers, beer manufacturers, cold manufacturers, etc. Next comes R728. The dry wire used as a gaseous refrigerant in some compression systems, especially aircraft for air conditioning. Only aircraft for air conditioning has some applications, almost that's also obsolete. R744, carbon dioxide. The principal refrigerant use of carbon dioxide is same as that of dry ice. It is taken non-toxic, non-toxic, and non-inflammable. But the boiling point of the refrigerant is extremely small. -73.6 degree at -50 degree centigrade. You see that at -50 degree pressure of well over 26.7 bar is required to prevent this evaporation. At the condenser temperature of +30 degree centigrade, a pressure of approximately 70 bar is required to liquefy the gas, and its critical temperature is 31 degree centigrade and trip to joint is -56.6 degree centigrade. Due to its high operating pressure, the compression of carbon dioxide refrigerator limit is very small, even for a comparatively large refrigerating capacity. However, because of this low efficiency and compared to other common refrigerants, it is seldom used in household units, but it is used in industrial applications and abroad ships. Next comes sulfur dioxide, R-764, sulfur dioxide. This refrigerant is produced for the compression for combination of sulfur and air. It is sulfur plus air. It was in formal years, it was widely used in household and small commercial units. The boiling point of sulfur dioxide is -10 degree centigrade and at atmospheric pressure. The condensing pressure varies between 4.1 bar and 6.2 bar under normal operating condition. The latent heat of sulfur dioxide at -396.5. It is a very stable refrigerant with its high critical temperature and non-flammable, non-explosive. It has a very unpleasant and irritating odor. This refrigerant is not injurious to food and used commercially as a ripener for preventive of food. It is, however, extremely injurious to flowers, plants, and shrubbery. But the sulfur dioxide in its pure state is not corrosive, but when it is in moisture present, the moisture of sulfurous acid is corrosive in its pure state. But when SO2 mixed with water, with water vapor, it is corrosive to this corrosive to atmosphere, corrosive to ions for steel. This is very important that the moisture in the refrigerant system to be a minimum itself. So there should be minimum amount of moisture present here. Minimum amount of moisture should present. Sulfur dioxide is not mixed readily with oil. So an oil lighter than the used with other refrigerant may be used in compressor. That refrigerant is in the evaporator and with oil floating on the top of it, top has a tendency to have a higher boiling point and then corresponding to the pressure. The modern evaporators overcome this by having the liquid introduced in such a way that the refrigerant is kept agitated while the unit is in operation. The leaks in the system with sulfur dioxide may be easily detected by means of soap solution or ammonia swab. A dense white smoke forms when sulfur dioxide and ammonia fumes come in contact. R-112 water. The principal refrigeration use of water is at ice. The high freezing temperature of water limits its use in vapor compression system. It is used as the temperature variance in some absorption systems and in system with system jet compression itself. Okay, let us finish here.